Staying with India, though, India's Congress Party leader Rahul Gandhi is now taking credit for the BJP government's accomplishments in the states. Rahul Gandhi says his actions managed to wake up the governments of Assam and Gujarat, both ruled by the BJP. Now, the issue that we are talking about is that of farmer loans. Remember, hectic politics has been underway for the last few days on that issue. The government think tank, Niti Aayog's chief, now has said that the governments do not work as Rahul Gandhi imagines. So there's a huge war of words that's playing out. The governments assess the financial situation and act accordingly, is what Niti Aayog has said. There is that criticism that's come in on your screens from Rahul Gandhi, the Congress Party chief. Let's play out a reaction for you as well.
ये तो वो वाली सी बात है कि मानो न मानो मैं ही चैंपियन, क्योंकि तो वो चीज़ जो है वो समझ में नहीं आई। ये कोई भी सरकारें और केंद्र सरकार भी कभी इस राहुल गांधी जी के कहने पर, मैं माफ़ी के साथ कहता हूँ कि वो ऐसा नहीं होता है। ये लोग अपना सब सारा कुछ देख के काम करती हैं और किसानों के हक में इस सरकार ने जितना काम किया है और जितना उन्होंने किया, वो मेरे ख्याल में कभी भी किसी और सरकार ने इतना नहीं किया और कभी भी किसी की हिम्मत नहीं हुई कि स्वामीनाथन कमेटी की रिकमेंडेशंस को मान्यता दे। इस सरकार ने वो किया। इस सरकार ने जो है वो किसानों के लिए क्रेडिट जो है वो 10.5 लाख करोड़ इस बार बढ़ाया गया, उसमें फसल बीमा योजना बनाई गई। तो राहुल गांधी का कहना ये मेरे ख्याल में बिल्कुल सर्वथा व्यर्थ है, क्योंकि ना तो केंद्र सरकार ना कोई और राज्य सरकार, उनकी सरकारें खुद ही उस पर अगर अमल कर लें तो काफी है। बाकी सरकारें जो अपना ठीक समझेंगी वो करेंगी।
All right, let's get in further perspectives now from Wion's political editor Karthike Sharma joining us from New Delhi. Karthike, as anticipated, the war of words over the sensitive issue of farmer loans and farmer waiver loans amplified over the last few hours.
You see, this is very unprecedented in Indian history, because farmer agitation and farmer politics somehow died after former Prime Minister Chaudhary Charan Singh, demitted himself from the political scene. And then most of the movement was caste-based social justice movement, and it got confederated into various state-level parties. For example, Mulayam Singh Yadav's party, Lalu Prasad Yadav's party. But what has happened in past 2 or 3 years is that the farmer as a political constituency has emerged, one. And secondly, Molly, the loans, the farmer loan issue has exerted so much of pressure on the current government that they themselves were forced to give out, to do away with the loan waiver in Assam. In fact, they wrote off 654 crores worth power dues in Gujarat. So there is a competition which is happening in this for the first time in 4.5 years that the opposition party has an upper hand on the narrative. And this is irking the ruling dispensation for one simple reason, because it has all happened very close to Lok Sabha elections. And they feel that if somehow Congress runs away with the agenda of the rural distress, they will really have a tough time, because primarily Bharatiya Janata Party in 2014 did well in those areas which are agrarian or dependent on agrarian economy.
Right, and also very interesting, Karthike, the usage of words coming in from the Niti Aayog. It's not very often that you see the think tank talking in this tone and tenor, lashing out at Rahul Gandhi, saying that he thinks he is the only champion.
Spot on. In fact, generally bureaucrats stay away from political issues. You will not find bureaucrats talking about it. But the very fact that the heat is being felt so intensely, Molly, on this issue, that every component of the government is now forced to come out and address the issue of rural distress. And let me tell you that this issue will not be limited to the 3 assembly elections we have seen. This issue will have tremendous ramification in Lok Sabha elections. You would remember in 2011, Mr. Gandhi tried his whole Bhatta Parsol sojourn, where he traveled for 40 kilometers from Delhi to Aligarh, failed. But somehow second time around, after 7 years, he has been able to deliver it. You might call him that second time Mr. Gandhi has been lucky, but first time he miserably failed, because after that he completely lost Uttar Pradesh to Samajwadi Party, where Congress was reduced to 29 seats in a house of 400.
Indeed, so very interesting war of words are playing out between the Niti Aayog and the Congress Party chief. We're going to leave it there for the moment, Karthike. Thanks very much for joining us with all of those perspectives.